This is a production of South Dakota Public Broadcasting, made possible by the Friends of SDPB. Pledge your support for quality programming. Call Friends at 800-333-0789 or donate online at sdpb.org. You may purchase this video and many others online at our website. Click on Shop SDPB. And thank you.
This high school activities championship event is conducted under the auspices of the South Dakota High School Activities Association.
Welcome back to the Sioux Falls Arena, the final night for the 2012-2013 basketball season. It's the Class AA tournament, and we are heading into our final session of the night. Coming up in a few minutes will be the third place game between Roosevelt and Lincoln. And then it's the championship between the Peer Governors and the Brandon Valley Lynx. I'm Steve Toome along with J.J. Hartigan. Welcome back here, third day at the state basketball tournament. And it all comes down to this one session. We'll have the third place game first, and then the big one for all the marbles, the Lynx against the Governors. Where else would you rather be?
Hey, this is going to be a raucous crowd tonight, a great crowd on hand already this evening, and we're expecting two great games today, starting with two teams from the city of Sioux Falls entertaining their home crowd here tonight, as you see the cheerleading section of the Roosevelt Rough Riders and their student section behind them. It's going to be a loud group over there tonight. Their team came into this tournament as the number one seed overall, but tonight we'll be playing the third place game against the sixth seed, Sioux Falls Lincoln, who narrowly, almost ever so closely, got to coming up with a win last night there against that to number two Peer team. But things just didn't go the way of the Sioux Falls Lincoln Patriots, and the Governors punched their ticket to the championship game. They'll be taking on Brandon Valley a little bit later on tonight. But there you get a bird's eye view of what the Sioux Falls Arena looks like here as we pile in, everybody. A lot of green, and that's not because St. Patrick's Day. Those are the Peer Governor fans who are here looking for, hopefully, a state championship at night's end.
And it has been a long time since the Governors won a championship. We'll talk about that a little bit later. Let's link the teams that'll be playing tonight. We'll start off with the designated visitor team tonight. That will be the Patriots of Sioux Falls Lincoln. They came in barely 500 on the year, but they've had a great run in this tournament. Came up 2 points short last night. Here is their starting lineup.
Yeah, you take a look. Nermin Kurzalich is going to be the heart and soul of this team. He left in the fourth quarter of game one back on Thursday, twisted his ankle. They didn't know if he'd go last night. Had a big impact for this Patriot team as he got into the starting lineup. He'll be there in the guard position along with Adam Jaros, the 6-foot senior. Caleb Rector has played great all tournament long. That 6'2 junior there, the third guard. And then Calvin Krause and Addison Park, two great post players there, both underclassmen, and have both been exceeding expectations as this tournament has rolled along.
Jaros has played standout ball, 16 points in both previous games. Now let's meet the starting lineup for the designated home team for this contest. That'll be the Rough Riders of Sioux Falls Roosevelt. Here's their starting five.
Yeah, and this is a team that lost just one game during the regular season, had a real tough loss against Brandon Valley yesterday, 57-51. But you see they're all seniors in this starting lineup. Four guards, Brandon Boggs, the big post player inside, Jeremiah Clark, Tyler Howard, the two guards there who will handle the rock for the most part. Nate Cole's going to be facilitating as well. And Lucas Weber, of course, has had a great tournament here in Sioux Falls.
Boggs had the great game in game one, 23 points, but he was held in check. Just 1 point last night in that loss to the Brandon Valley Lynx. Tyler Howard signed to play at the University of Chicago. Lucas Wilbur, he's going to Augustana, I think, football, baseball. Great all-around athlete there. He rounds out that starting five for the Roosevelt Rough Riders. Look for Colton Coima, Chris Phillips, and Trevon Moody to come off the bench for the Rough Riders, and look for Malik Dunn and Luke Myers to come off the bench for the Lincoln Patriots. Really in a question of the third place game, considering both teams lost close ones, who can get fired up for this game? Let's get ready for the starting lineups. Here's our public address announcer.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the final session of the 2013 State AA Boys Basketball Tournament. Each year, the South Dakota High School Activities Association sponsors statewide events in athletics, journalism, music, and speech activities. The Activities Association, along with its corporate partners, Sanford Health, First Premier Bank, Premier Bank Card, Farmers Union Insurance Agency, Billion Automotive, and the South Dakota Army National Guard, believe that these athletic and fine arts activities provide lessons for life, including the lessons taught with good sportsmanship. We hope that you enjoy tonight's state tournament games and that you let your good sportsmanship show. Tonight, we shall crown the 28th state champion for Class AA boys basketball. Please welcome the teams that played this afternoon in the first game, including the cheerleaders from the Raiders of Rapid City Stevens High School. Carrying their school colors is Tara Nilsson. And the Cobblers of Rapid City Central High School. Their school colors are carried by Tori Holt. In the Consolation Championship game were the Tigers of Huron High School. Kenzie DeYoung is carrying the school colors. And the Bobcats of Brookings High School. Carrying the school colors is Casey Brown. In this evening's first game, playing for the third and fourth places are the Rough Riders of Sioux Falls Roosevelt High School. Carrying their school colors is Stephen Tisdell. And the Patriots of Sioux Falls Lincoln High School. Rachel Phillips is carrying the school colors. In tonight's championship game, we have the Lynx of Brandon Valley High School. Haley Carmody is carrying the school colors. And their opponents, the Governors of Pierre Riggs High School. Alyssa Bump is carrying their flag. Ladies and gentlemen, would you please now stand and face the flag of our country as our national anthem is sung by a quartet from the Sioux Falls Lincoln High School, including Ben Gerter, Joe Gullickson, Charlie Mogan, and Adam Rye. We remind everyone in attendance that the proper respect is to remove your hat, face the flag, and stand at attention with your right hand over your heart. Veterans and active duty military not in uniform may salute the flag. Ladies and gentlemen, our national anthem.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight. O'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets' red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say, does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Thank you.
and gentlemen, welcome once again to this session of the State AA Boys Basketball Tournament. And this contest for third place featuring the Patriots from Sioux Falls, Lincoln. And the Rough Riders from Sioux Falls, Roosevelt. Before we meet our starting lineups, let's meet our cheerleaders tonight. Beginning with the cheerleaders from the Lincoln Patriots. They are Courtney Anderson, Sydney Bartles, Lily Brueckelman, Katharina Frericks, Mackenzie Jones, Kelsey Sowers, and Hannah Stock. Cheer coaches are Katie Pepst and Katie Hopp. And let's meet the cheerleaders from the Roosevelt Rough Riders. Carissa Adams, Shelby Anderson, Kylie Krager, Jade Jasper, Alyssa Ketchum, Kara Sullivan, Stephanie Terrian, and Kayla Y. Cheer coaches are Katie Hevlin, Brianna Drake, and Kayla Meyerhoff. Now, ladies and gentlemen, let's meet the starting lineups for this game. Introduced alternately and beginning with the Lincoln Patriots. Starting at a guard, a 6'2" senior, number 13, Nermin Kurzalich. And starting at a guard for the Roosevelt Rough Riders, a 5'11" senior, number 2, Jeremiah Clark. Starting at a guard for the Lincoln Patriots, a 6-foot senior, number 43, Adam Jaros. And starting at a guard for the Roosevelt Rough Riders, a 5'10" senior, number 5, Nate Cole. Starting at a forward for the Lincoln Patriots, a 6'2" junior, number 23, Caleb Rector. And starting at a forward for the Roosevelt Rough Riders, a 6'1" senior, number 3, Tyler Howard. Starting at a forward for the Lincoln Patriots, a 6'4" junior, number 35, Kelvin Krause. And starting at a forward for the Roosevelt Rough Riders, a 6'3" senior, number 22, Lucas Wilbur. Starting at center for the Patriots, a 6'5" sophomore, number 51, Addison Park. And starting at center for the Rough Riders, a 6'4" senior, number 4, Brandon Boggs. Ladies and gentlemen, the assistant coaches for the Lincoln Patriots are Scott Embry, Eric Rice, Jared Jensen, Matt Daly, and John Vining. Assistant coaches for the Roosevelt Rough Riders are Ben DeWard, Jay Wang, Adam Quayle, Tyler Wrench, and Greg Henderson. The head coach of the Lincoln Patriots is Jeff Halseth. Head coach of the Roosevelt Rough Riders is Lee Taylor. The officials for this game are Jim Ricketts Jr., Everett Gebhardt, and Jim Johnston.
All right, we're ready to go in this third place game between the Rough Riders and the Patriots. Teams meeting at center court. It'll be Boggs and Krause. jumping at center. Great that you could be along tonight with us for the final night of the boys' AA tournament here on SDPB2, South Dakota Public Broadcasting. My name's Steve Toome, along with J.J. Hartigan. Ball's in the air, and it's controlled by Roosevelt. Roosevelt won both meetings during the regular season, one in overtime. The other, that was a two-point win. The other one was by 14 points. Lob to Boggs. Has a tough time controlling. Spins, can't finish. Tough angle. He had to really work hard to even get a shot attempt. And the rebound to Lincoln.
Yeah, Boggs is going to have his work cut out against these tall, physical post players for Lincoln. He might be older than them, but they can really match up size-wise and with strength underneath.
In the corner, Cole drives, gets around Krause, and the shot is missed, but he gets his own rebound, puts it up, no good this time. Krause clears it away. And I think Lincoln kind of dodged a bullet there on that one. Cole, by... love to have that shot back. Inside, tapped away, Boggs. Cole saves it along the baseline. Lobs ahead. Here's Boggs. Finishes. Brandon Boggs. First points of the game, and now the pressure being applied by Roosevelt. Jaros. Krzalek, the two seniors, and Rector can't save it. Nearly goes into the scorer's table. Turnover, Patriots. Malik Dunn quickly into the game. He will replace Addison Park. It'll be Wilbur to trigger near midcourt. Jeff Halsett there, head coach for the Patriots. Man-to-man for Lincoln as Wilbur drives. It's shut off. Howard gets loose along the baseline. Oh, layup a bit short. Saved by Cole, out to Wilbur. His pass to the corner to Noah, actually went to our cameraman over there. One of the students from Washington, out of bounds to Lincoln. They'll face the pressure. Jaros calling for it, and it's tipped and stolen. Howard, no. But boy, not good execution on the inbounds play for the Patriots. And I think Lincoln may just be calling a timeout here. They will. Timeout called, a 30-second timeout called by the Patriots. They're down 2-0 and had some problems getting the ball inbounds that last timeout. We'll keep you up to date on all the other tournaments around the state. The B getting underway up in Aberdeen, and of course the A tournament will start in about an hour, a little less than an hour, out in Rapid City. Don't forget, for a DVD of the championship tournament for either girls or boys basketball, your favorite team, 1995 is the cost. $5 in shipping and handling as well. The number to call, 1-800-456-0766, or you can log on to sdpb.org. Tyler Howard at the line, 59% on the season. Signed to play at the University of Chicago, 6'1 senior for the Rough Riders. Well short, barely drew iron. Krzalek brings it up, hounded by Clark. Roosevelt man-to-man, tipped out of bounds by Howard. It will stay with Lincoln. Krzalek gets the inbounds. Trying to post up Prowse. Rector on the drive. It's tipped away, but a Lincoln player gets it. Under 10 on the shot clock. Krzalek drives. Missed it. Tipped outside, collected by Cole. Works his way around Dunn. In the open court, Cole nearly lost it. Almost a double dribble. Boggs will help settle him down. And the Rough Riders reset. Howard, strong move. Little short. Tipped once, twice, three times. No one has it near. Now Roosevelt collects it. Cole Thought about the three, goes cross court to Boggs. He'll fire it over Kraus, and it's good. Brandon Boggs, 5 points out of the gate for Roosevelt.
Well, he needed to get involved here early tonight. Again, we highlighted his struggles throughout the day yesterday. Getting into the flow now here against Lincoln, getting out to a great start with 5 points.
And foul on the floor, that's gonna be against Tyler Howard, and that is his first foul. Timeout on the court. You're watching the Class AA State Boys Basketball Tournament on SDPB2, South Dakota Public Broadcasting. In Sioux Falls, a slow start for the Patriots. They haven't scored yet. Roosevelt leads 6-0. And Lincoln will have the ball.
As we said right before the break, as Kurzalic shoots the three, Boggs for Roosevelt. Had an off day offensively yesterday. He was just 1 of 3 from the floor, had 1 point in that game.
Yeah, 23 the first day. He got into foul trouble early and just never really got into the rhythm of the game as Lincoln keeps it. Dunn spins, hesitates, off the side of the rim. It's loose. Players fighting for it. Clark comes away with it, lobs it ahead to Cole. He'll fire the jumper, and he got it.
Cole had a frustrating day. He was in foul trouble throughout the afternoon.
And it's going to be off of Caleb Rector, out of bounds to Roosevelt. As Lincoln not in sync here in this early going. They played two hard-fought contests on the previous days to get into this third place game. As Roosevelt operates in the front court. And a foul down low. Let's see who this is on. Two free throws coming up for Roosevelt. And that'll be on Krasalik. And that is his first. Boggs now with 6 points in the game. Krasalik out, Luke Myers in for the Patriots. Got them both. 10-0, Roosevelt. Quickly, they get a tip, and it's in the hands of Boggs. He'll fire the long three, it's short. Rebound tipped near the bucket, tipped away from a Lincoln player into the hands of Clark. He's double-teamed along the baseline, drives off balance. Dunn clears it away. Jarls will try to settle it down now, facing a little bit of pressure. Backs away, Howard will shadow him up the court. Jaros fires a three, and no good, and Cole up high for the board. Roosevelt will run, Wilbur around Jaros, missed it. Rector gets the rebound.
Jaros got him got his body set there for a potential charge. Got Wilbur off balance enough, he had to take that extra step to get around him, and I think he might have rushed the shot just a little bit.
Myers feeds it. Dunn gets the first points of the game for the Patriots.
And that stops an 0-for-4 day for the Patriots from the floor.
Cole quickly answers. Nate Cole, slick jumper there. Jaros in trouble, gets it into Rector, now gets it back. Well, here comes Clark, chasing from behind. The pass is tipped, but back to Jaros. He'll dribble along the baseline, is bumped. Rector, a three. Short, rebound, back to Rector, loses it, got it back. He'll have to reset with Myers. And it's tipped away by Howard, he read that one. And Tyler Howard, his first bucket of the game.
Just lazy passing right now for the Patriots. It seems like it's one-handed passes or lob passes in the air. Those are readable, and the Roosevelt Rough Riders have been all over them here so far today. You gotta look for crisp, strong passes, especially around the perimeter.
Jaros will be fouled by Nate Cole, and that's his first, team second. Here's almost a line change coming in here for the Patriots, or for the Rough Riders, I should say. In fact, they will bring on 5 new players. Colton Coima, Chris Phillips, Trevon Moody, Also into the game, Josh Kirkwald and Ryan Leslie.
This is a Roosevelt team that doesn't have an underclassman below the junior class. All juniors and seniors on this team. It's getting some valuable playing time here at the state tournament level now for some of these younger guys, while getting a breather there with the 10-12 point edge right now for the Rough Riders.
Pass out of bounds. And Lincoln bringing a couple subs. Kurzawicz replaced Jaros. Kraus out and Park in. And here comes Zach Campbell, the 5'7 senior, his first tournament appearance for Luke Myers. Here's Ryan Leslie into the front court. Phillips at the high post. Across the lane, Krzalich tried to steal it. Almost came in the back door and picked his pocket. Plenty of time to work with on the shot clock. Koima has had a good tournament. Nice fake. The drive, the circus shot, no good, and Dunn clears the rebound. Krzalich spins and walks right into a jump ball.
Yeah, I don't know that he noticed that Kirkwald was standing right behind him, and as soon as Krzalich had that spin move there at the free throw line, he ran into the defender. Two defenders in his way and nowhere to go, and it'll luckily stay in the Patriots' possession here, but 28 on the shot clock.
Dunn, bounce pass, down low, good play. Caleb Rector finishes it off. Nice pass by Dunn off the inbounds, and Campbell will get tagged for the foul, his first. And that is the third team foul on Lincoln. Inbounds comes to Moody. He'll be double teamed. Now the pressure backs away. Phillips will handle, looking for help. Hands off to Leslie. Koima had 15 points the first game, held to 6 last night. Gets the ball now. Rector picks him up. Koima likes to shoot the threes. Moody, the drive, the pull-up, no good. Dunn tips it. Phillips had it, but Malik Dunn took it away from him. 10 seconds difference between the shot clock and game clock. Campbell, skip pass. Rector couldn't get it to go, fighting for his own rebound. Throws it up, no good. Dunn tried to tip it to the outside. It comes to the hands of Roosevelt. Kirkwald finds Koima. Three, good. He's been making 11 out on that three-point line. 8 seconds left. Krzalich is going to have to hurry. He's taking his time. Now he'll go in, pass down low, intercepted, and Campbell ties up Kirkwald, no shot attempt. We're done with one. 17-4 Roosevelt. This is the Class AA Boys Basketball Tournament on SDPB2, South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
Free statewide broadcast of this high school championship event is underwritten by the thousands of members of the Friends of South Dakota Public Broadcasting, by Mid-Continent Communications, and by Dakota Bank.
We're back at the arena in Sioux Falls. Roosevelt dominates period number one. They're up 17-4. Boggs leading the way with 7. Starters back out on the floor for the Rough Riders. Cole, backdoor cut. Wilbur will get free throws.
Yeah, it'll be on Addison Park, and I don't think he thought that the foul should have been called there. He had a little choice words for the officials there, but Park picking up his first.
Yep.
Fourth team foul already.
Fourth team foul on Lincoln. And Wilbur into the scoring column tonight. He's a 69% free throw shooter on the season. And he makes them both. 19-4, the pressure continues. Jaros working hard, triple team, gives way to Krzalich. Campbell lobs it down low. Park outside Jaros, long three, good. Patriots needed that one desperately. Jaros, his first points of the game, but quickly bogs the other way in traffic. Can't get it. Tapped out of bounds off of Lincoln. It'll stay with Roosevelt. Nate Cole the trigger along the baseline. Bounce pass into Howard. Oh, what a pretty play. Howard with five. And it's tapped out of bounds. And Kraus will now be the trigger man, facing pressure from Roosevelt. Looking for Campbell. He feeds Jaros. Quickly up court. Two on one. Jaros lost the handle. But he'll get the layup.
Yeah, he might have dribbled that off the right side of his hip there as he tried to hustle down the near sideline. Was able to recover, though, and to secure the bucket for Lincoln.
Clark fires a three. It's good. Jeremiah Clark with the tray. 15-point edge as Jaros looks up court. Behind the back dribble. Weaves through traffic. Spots a man. Kraus wasn't ready for it. Off his fingertips. Out of bounds to the Rough Riders. And we have a 30-second timeout called. And let's see who called that one. I believe it was Lincoln who called that one. Well, Roosevelt takes the timeout. So that'll leave them four remaining, as it will for Lincoln. Coming up on April the 22nd, the Antiques Roadshow episode you've been waiting for, the first of three, recorded last July in South Dakota. And that'll be at 7 Central 6 Mountain Time coming up April 22nd, Antiques Roadshow from Rapid City, South Dakota.
Let's take a look at these numbers for the team so far today. Lincoln, just 4 of 11 from the floor, 36%. Roosevelt, 8 of 19, though, 42%. They've knocked down 3 of 4 three-point attempts so far today. Lincoln, just 1 of 4 from beyond the arc here at the moment.
Here's a drive by Cole, and Campbell will collect his second foul. And that is the 15th foul on the Patriots. Cole gets it back in play. Wilbur out on top. Bounce pass, back door. Campbell, nice read, tips it away. Connor Burchill into the game. Feeds it ahead. Park, stripped from him by Wilbur. Here comes Jeremiah Clark. The drive. And he's going to be fouled on his move to the bucket. Not in the act of shooting. And this will be on Addison Park, and that's his second. Kraus in, Park out for the Patriots.
Park has two personal fouls now, by the way. 16 fouls for the Patriots here with 6:18 left to go in this first half. That's not good news for Lincoln. They need their big man inside. Dunn can handle the job, but they're going to need both Dunn and Park throughout much of this game here today.
Kraus ends up with a loose ball and a push foul against Brandon Boggs. Third foul on the Rough Riders.
Just his first personal, by the way.
Mm-hmm. And here comes the pressure again. Campbell gets the inbounds. Head to Burchill. Well, he's going to be fouled as he hit the deck. And that'll be on Jeremiah Clark. Team's fourth, his first. Connor Burchill, 6'2 junior, will put her in play. Campbell lobs it down low. Here's Dunn. Working hard. Can't get the bucket. Moody clears the rebound.
Boggs tried to sell the charge there, but no whistle on the play. Now he's wide open in the right wing, but Dunn's going to rip it out of the air.
Yep, miscommunication. No. Player for Roosevelt didn't see the entry pass. Read by Dunn all the way. Jaro stops and pops, and it's no good. Up high, Moody. Cole fights away from Campbell, trying to clear some space. Campbell settles in defensively. Here's Cole, puts it up and in. 26-9. This one's been all Roosevelt, and we're going to have a contact foul in the front court, and it's going to be on Roosevelt, and that's going to be on Moody, and that's his first, team's fifth. Kritzalich in and Campbell out for Lincoln, Wilbur out and Phillips in for Roosevelt. Fresh shot clock for the Patriots to work with as they'll play it in from side court. Burchill looking inside. Boggs covers up Dunn, can't get it to him. Kritzalich drives, floats it partially blocked in the hands of Moody. Kritzalich gets a steal back. Feeds Dunn, but it's tipped away from him. Boggs has it. Oh, a pass was tipped, but Phillips will finish. Point lead, and Phillips gets a steal. And he'll finish, and a blocking foul called on Adam Jaros. First on Jaros, 17th foul on the Lincoln Patriots, and Chris Phillips to the line, a 70% free throw shooter on the season. And he's got it. Timeout on the court. This is the Class AA State Boys Basketball Tournament on SDPB2, South Dakota Public Broadcasting. We are back at the arena in Sioux Falls. Steve Toome and J.J. Hartigan here. Third place game. It's been all Roosevelt so far. And Lincoln faces the pressure coming out of the timeout after the three-point play by Chris Phillips. Burchill weaves through traffic. Kraus, who nearly lost it. Jaros fakes the three. What a fake. Fires it in and out. Dunn puts it back in. Malik Dunn, the sophomore, has had a good tournament. Lob ahead to Moody. But the Rough Riders will have to play the half-court game here as they didn't have the numbers. Okoyma almost had it tipped away by Burchill. Lincoln bench was claiming that was a double dribble. Jaros picks up Howard. Now the switch to Kritzalich. The drive. Can't finish with the left hand. Kritzalich has it tipped away from him, and it's saved by Moody. Lob ahead. Phillips has to collect it. Passes. Kirkwall to finish. Kritzalich. They'll get it to Jaros. Jaros will be bumped on his, no, you're gonna say he stepped out of bounds. And the turnover gives it back to Roosevelt as Caleb Rector will check in and he'll replace Jaros. So Lincoln will apply a little pressure as Howard gets it in. Roosevelt. Nick Cole does most of the ball handling, but Roosevelt with so many interchangeable parts. They have about four or five guys that could probably be point guards if they wanted to exclusively. Three no good from Phillips. Rector has the board, tumbles to the ground, and a timeout called by the Lincoln Patriots to save the possession. They are down by a bunch here. 30-second timeout coming up. You got an update from one of the other tournaments here, JJ?
Let's take a look around the rest of the state here and see what's going on. Right now, South Central taking on Dupree. And that one in the second quarter, 21-15. And nothing else going on around the rest of the state yet, but we'll be getting some games going on elsewhere here shortly.
Yep, a tournament out in Rapid City. That'll start in about 20 minutes from now. That's on SDPB3 television, the B. If you want to watch that, that's on SDPB1. And a full night of basketball across all three SDPB channels. And online at sdpb.org. It'll be Kraus to put it in play. Gets it in Kritzalich. Feeds it ahead. Rector. Cross court. Now underneath. Dunn. And did he travel? Nope, he was fouled.
Yeah, Dunn's going to go to the line for two here. He kind of stutter stepped for a moment, tried to get the defense in the air, and by doing so, got the foul, but he also missed what would have been an easy layup there on the offensive end. Either way, chance at the free throw line here for Malik as he misses his first.
Boggs in, Wilbur in, Clark in, Cole in, so looks like the starting five back in for the Rough Riders. As Dunn, the sophomore, 6'4", stands at the line for the second of two. Boggs clears it away.
Right now, a quiet and stunned Lincoln student section. It just seems like the Patriots have come out a little flat here today, and you gotta wonder if maybe after losing the way they did last night has left a bit of a hangover for these Lincoln Patriots here as they get into the third place game today.
Yeah, Lincoln's had to work so hard. They had to fight hard to win that first game against Brookings. They took Pierre down to the wire last night, lost by two, had a chance on a long three-pointer as Rector fires a shot, no good. Kraus gets it back, no good. Rebound, loose on the floor. Burchill picks it up. Oh, he's blocked by Howard, but a foul on the Rough Riders.
That'll be Howard's second personal for Sioux Falls Roosevelt. Actually, yep.
Yep, 17 foul, and it'll set Connor Burchill to the line for a pair. No good.
Lincoln 0 for 3 from the free throw line here so far today. Just 5 of 18 from the floor, shooting 28% here right now against Roosevelt.
But he got that one. 21 point edge, Roosevelt. They've been the team on fire tonight. As Cole scans over the defense. Howard drives. Krzalich tried to steal it from him. No good. Kraus pulls down the rebound. Slapped out of his hands by Boggs. Kraus tried. Oh my goodness. Jump ball. As Cole hit the deck. That was either jump ball or first down. I couldn't determine which one. As Burchill checks out. And the alternating possession gives the ball to Lincoln. Kraus looking around. Gets it quickly into Jaros. Charles, double teamed. Oh, Krzalich, oh, he might have tweaked that ankle again. Oh, he's in pain.
Well, it looked like Wilbur came in and tried to just check up on the on Krzalich there near the half court line, maybe just match up with his defender, and as he came in, kicked him in the ankle. It was accidental contact to be sure. As Krzalich exits the game here, and he's gonna be checked out by the training staff, but again, that ankle, he twisted it late in the game on day one. And he was able to play yesterday, but got kicked pretty good there just a moment ago.
Yeah, accidental contact there. As Rector nearly lost it, Jaros has it. Jaros, long three off the side of the rim. Tipped once, twice, but to Kraus, no good. And we got a player on the floor. And there's a foul on Roosevelt. And that is on Lucas Wilbur, and that'll be his first. Team's eight. Kraus at the line, he had the score in the game, had 7 the first game, 6 last night. Misfires on that one. And it's one of those situations for Lincoln, when it rains, it pours. Huron kind of had a similar deal their first game out when they only scored 29 points. Oh, and young man here, I think he might have got cut.
Yeah, Kraus has a little bit of a gash underneath his left knee. He'll need to get checked out by the training staff, and now the Lincoln training staff here is working double overtime all of a sudden, taking care of Krzalich's leg, even though he's coming back in after getting that ankle evaluated. Now
they'll focus in on Krause's left knee.
Grzalic, he'll come back on. He is favoring one leg, a little bit of a limp as he'll step to the line. Now, he will face Krause, so he will get the second free throw attempt. He has yet to score in this game. And he's got that free throw. Nearing halftime here, we'll have award presentations at halftime for the teams that played this afternoon. A long free throw, or a long three-pointer, I should say. Krzalic gets the rebound, stumbled a little bit through traffic. And the shot clock, game clock virtually tied, but Rector gets the three-pointer for the Patriots.
Still a long way to go for Sioux Falls Lincoln, but that's going to help the cause big time. Getting a little bit of momentum and maybe some luck on the side of the Patriots here as they head into halftime.
Cole plays for the last shot. Howard picked up by Jaros. Gets a screen. Rector steals the ball away. He's got two. Jaros sees the clock. And no good, and we are at halftime. This is the Class AA Boys Basketball Tournament. We'll be back in a moment right here on South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
Free statewide broadcast of this high school championship event is underwritten by the thousands of members of the Friends of South Dakota Public Broadcasting, by Mid-Continent Communications, and by Dakota Bank.
All right, back at the arena, time to hand out some awards. Here's Jason Luth, our public address announcer.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Each year, the South Dakota High School Activities Association is proud to present its Distinguished Service Award to individuals who have made a significant contribution to the furtherance of high school activities in our state. The recipients of this award exemplify the very highest ideals of service to the association and to the youth of our state. Ladies and gentlemen, it is with the deepest gratitude that the South Dakota High School Activities Association's Distinguished Service Award is being presented this evening. Please welcome to present these awards Terry Nebelsek of Huron and Chris Specht of Yankton from the South Dakota High School Activities Association Board of Directors. Assisting with the presentation is Wayne Carney, Executive Director of the South Dakota High School Activities Association. Our first Distinguished Service Award recipient is Rebecca Eklund of Brookings. Rebecca Eklund graduated from Augustana College with a major in English and obtained a graduate degree in curriculum and instruction from South Dakota State University. She has taught English for 38 years in Minnesota, Nebraska, North Dakota, and South Dakota, and the past 28 years at Brookings High School, where she is the yearbook advisor. Ladies and gentlemen, presenting the Distinguished Service Award, Chris Specht of Yankton to Rebecca Eklund of Brookings. Our next recipient is Rod Garrison of Sioux Falls. Rod Garrison was a teacher for 43 years. He began his coaching career as the Little League baseball coach in Tyndall, South Dakota in 1967. He has served in a variety of positions at O'Gorman High School in Sioux Falls for the past 34 years, including 28 years as head coach in the golf program, 21 years as assistant football coach, and 5 years as head track coach. He is currently the executive director of the Sioux Empire Junior Golf Association. Presenting the award is Chris Specht, Distinguished Service recipient, Rod Garrison. Our next Distinguished Recipient Award is presented to Linda Hengveld of Sioux Falls. Linda Hengveld has had a key role in South Dakota interscholastic activities for the past 28 years. Beginning in 1988, she spent 5 years at Brandon Valley High School as an assistant to the principals and the athletic director. After 4 years at Sioux Falls, Washington, She has worked for the past 15 years with Mark Miley as the Assistant Coordinator of Athletics and Physical Education in the Sioux Falls Schools. Linda has served as the Assistant Meet or Tournament Manager for numerous state events, including wrestling, volleyball, boys and girls basketball, tennis, golf, and cross country. Ladies and gentlemen, presenting the Distinguished Service Award is Wayne Kearney to Linda Hengeveld of Sioux Falls. Our next Distinguished Service Award is presented to Bob Lowry of Pierre. Bob Lowry received his Bachelor of Science degree from Peru State College in 1976 and earned his Master of Science degree from SDSU in 1982. He was cross-country and track coach at Vermilion High School for 17 years and also serves as the school's athletic director for 9 years. Bob retired on June 30th, 2012, after serving 18 years as an assistant executive director for the South Dakota High School Activities Association. Ladies and gentlemen, Terry Nebelsek is presenting a Distinguished Service Award to Bob Lowry. Our final Distinguished Service Award is presented to Mark Miley of Sioux Falls. Mark Miley has held an administrator position in the South Dakota High Schools for over 27 years. Beginning in 1986, he was athletic director at Brandon Valley High School for 5 years, then moved to Sioux Falls Roosevelt for 2 years. For the past 20 years, Miley has been the coordinator of athletics and physical education for the Sioux Falls Schools. Mr. Miley has served as the meet or tournament manager for numerous state events, including wrestling, gymnastics, volleyball, and boys and girls basketball, tennis, golf, cross country, and track. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Wayne Kearney presenting a Distinguished Service Award to Mark Miley. Complete biographies of each Distinguished Award recipient can be found in the state basketball program. Other South Dakota High School Activities Association Distinguished Service Awards for the 2012-13 school year will be presented at other state athletic, music, and speech activities throughout the year. Next, ladies and gentlemen, we will present awards to the teams that played this afternoon in the consolation games. Welcome to present the awards this evening on behalf of the South Dakota High School Activities Association, Board of Directors members, Terry Nebelsek of Huron and Chris Specht of Yankton. Assisting with the award presentation and representing the association's corporate partners are Mike Begeman from Sanford Health, T.J. Hora from First Premier Bank, Premier Bank Card, Larry Sutton from Farmers Union Insurance, and Sergeant First Class Nick Cusenberry from the South Dakota Army National Guard. The first team to receive their awards tonight for eighth place are the Cobblers from Rapid City Central. Team members include Jake Seals, Tanner Sumption, Tucker Berg, Parker Schnabel, Levi Pyle, Ian Barse, Ryan Clemens, Jesse Riddle, John Fierro, Josh Dotson, Noah Fensky, Nathan Miller, Jordan Warner, Trevor Lorenz, and Mitchell Newhouse. Team managers are Victoria Blair, Katie Wimp, and Peyton Clark. Assistant coaches are Steve Anderson, Keith Holzer, Chris Clark, Jeff Wimp, and Roman Gentry. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome head coach of the Rapid City Central Cobblers, Mike Purcell. Next to receive their awards are the winners of our first game this afternoon, the Rapid City Stevens Raiders. Team members include Brad Drake, Steven Schaefer, Josh Johnson, Matt Minnick, Jacob Vifquain, Trey Olson, Matt Wilson, Terrence Richard, Cody Norberg, JJ Cunningham, Sam McLeod, Tanner Simons, Chris James, Brett Bennett, Kevin Blackett, Ska Blackbear, Wyatt Astus, and Ben Sorensen. Team managers are Maudie Smeal, Catherine Sterling, and Tori Buss. Assistant coaches are Adam Dannenbring, Jason Olson, Travis Schwartz, and Mitch Demers. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the head coach of the Stevens Raiders, receiving the trophy for seventh place, Darius Buss. Our next team to receive their awards are the Huron Tigers. Team members are Houston Hines, Josh Brooks, J.P. Noonan, Will Carr, Alex Kaufman, Lucas Morrison, Carter Brotherton, Mason Staley, James White, Adam Zwanzinger, Caleb Carr, Hayden Bush, Trey Henderson, Tate Spohr, and Justin Decker. Team managers are Madison DeYoung, Harry Dahl, Angie Reyna, Solin Mack, Mason Rosell, and Tenley Buddenhagen. Assistant coaches are Bob DeBoer, Tom Reed, Chris Rosell, and Eric Hall. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the head coach of the Huron Tigers to receive the sixth place trophy, Tim Buttenhagen. And now the winners of the second game this afternoon. Fifth place, our consolation champions, the Brookings Bobcats. Team members are Seth Frazier, Carter Gordon, Zach Sell, Jordan Verhoek, Jared Cheddar, Zach Kress, Braxton Carlson, Mac Burns, Mikey Daniel, Trevor Hornig, Caleb Vig, Connor Bestie, Seth Morrett, Tyler Nagy, Zach Page, Austin May, RJ Helsper, and Bryce McMackin. Team trainer is Angela Brown. Team managers are Justin Johnson and Michael Reinerson. Statistician is Aaron Jornby. Assistant coaches are Tim Leese, Isaac Hansen, and Taylor Johnson. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome receiving the Consolation Champion Trophy, head coach Travis Ingebretson. Congratulations to all the team members who participated in the games this afternoon. Awards for third and fourth place will be presented at halftime of the next game.
And we'll be back with more in a moment. This is the Class AA Boys Basketball Tournament on SDPB2, South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
Free statewide broadcast of this high school championship event is underwritten by the thousands of members of the Friends of South Dakota Public Broadcasting, by Farmers Union Insurance, Independent Insurance Agents of South Dakota, SDN Communications, and First Bank and Trust.
The arena in Sioux Falls, there's our halftime score. The third place game, Roosevelt ahead of Lincoln with the halftime stats. Here's JJ Hartigan.
Well, Sioux Falls Roosevelt off to a red-hot start here so far today. 12 of 29 from the floor, 41%. And they were 3 of 6 in that first half there from the three-point arc, shooting 50% as a team, and 6 of 7 from the free throw line at an 86% clip. They were led in that first half by the 7 points of Brandon Boggs, erasing an 0-for-3 day, yesterday, and getting just the 1 point in that semifinal game. But he has 7 points, 1 rebound, 2 steals in 12 minutes here so far today. 6 points, 4 rebounds on 3 of 7 shooting for Nate Cole. He's got 3 assists and a steal so far today in 12 minutes. Other scores for the Rough Riders: 5 points for Tyler Howard, 5 points for Chris Phillips. Let's see here, 3 points on the day for Colton Koima and for Jeremiah Clark, and 2 points so far this evening for Lucas Weber and for Josh Kirkwood. The only players who've gotten into the game today or who are yet to score: Trayvon Moody, 0-for-2 so far today, and Ryan Leslie, who has not attempted a shot so far for Sioux Falls Roosevelt in 2 minutes of action. For Sioux Falls Lincoln, they finished the first half struggling from the floor, 6 of 22, shooting 27%. They were just 2 of 7 from three-point land at a 29% clip there in the first half, and just 2 of 6 from the free throw line, shooting 33% from the charity stripe. Leading score for Sioux Falls Lincoln so far today, 5 points from Caleb Rector. He's joined by,
Adam Jaros, who's got five as well. He's 2 of 7 from the floor. Rector, 2 of 6. Just 4 points so far for Malik Dunn. And 1 point apiece here so far today for Nermin Krzalic and for Connor Burchill.
8 different players have scored for the Rough Riders. 5 different players have scored for Lincoln. Points in the paint, 16-8 edge Roosevelt. Bench points, 10-5 edge Roosevelt. Fast break points, 6-2 Roosevelt. Points off turnovers, 8-0 Roosevelt. I think we're detecting a pattern here. Roosevelt has dominated this game from the get-go. They were up 17-4 after the first period. Lincoln played much better in the second quarter, but Roosevelt still outscored them 16-12, and that's why they lead 33-16 here at the intermission. And for Jeff Hallseth, you know, what do you say to your kids at halftime? Hey, just start fresh and take it from there.
Well, you could tell Sioux Falls Lincoln came out loose and relaxed today here. Maybe just a little bit too loose and relaxed. Let's see if maybe they have a fire lit under them as they come out in the second half, see if they can't turn things around. But for Sioux Falls Roosevelt, business as usual. It has been a great day offensively for them. Keep looking for Mr. Boggs down low and see if he can't continue to dominate the way he has so far today. Again, a little bit poor shooting, just 2 of 6, but he does have 7 points, has gotten to the free throw line, and has come up with a couple of key steals here so far today for Roosevelt. So look for him to stay active. Nermin Krzalic is going to have to get involved here as well. He's got just 1 point today, 3 turnovers in the first half. Look for him to have a better second half in what could be his final game in a Lincoln uniform.
Yeah, and you know, for Nermin Krzalic, of course, he's out there on the ankle. It's not 100%. He tweaked it there in the first half when Wilbur accidentally stepped on it. And again, we do emphasize it was an accident there, you know, right near half court. And for Nermin, you know, a fantastic player. He'll come out here and start the second half, but he's going to have to play through that pain and try to rally his team here. Down by a bunch. Third quarter about to get underway. Roosevelt starts the period with the ball. Starting 5 on the court for both teams. Lincoln goes man to man. Here's a near steal by Kraus. Wilbur loses it. Kraus saves it to Jaros. There's a play Lincoln needs as they force the turnover. Now here comes the double team and it's tipped. Oh, Jaros lost the sight of it. Cole picks it up, he's shoved by Kraus. And that's his first foul of the second half for either team. So Lincoln makes a play, and then the athletic prowess of Roosevelt gets the ball back. And they'll feed it down low, and it's picked off by Lincoln. Rector ahead, Park had it tipped away. Boggs touched it last, Lincoln basketball. Jaros gets it in, can't get away a shot. Krzalic, oh, Clark hit the deck. Shot no good, Park, and he traveled along the baseline. Clark, he crumbled, kind of twisted oddly near the top of the key, but he's gonna be okay. He does wear a brace on that right knee as he walks up court. As Cole brings it up, Krzalic guards him. Howard. Nice move by Clark. Pretty shot, can't get it to fall, but Howard keeps it alive, and he'll get some free throws as there's a Lincoln foul on the baseline. And that's gonna be on Adam Jaros, his second. Tyler Howard to the line, 5 points. 1 of 2 at the line today. Missed that one. This Roosevelt team set a lot of team records. Most points scored in a season. I believe most three-pointers scored. Gets a second. They scored 91 points this year. That a school record. Many fans of Roosevelt thought they'd be playing the second game on Saturday night. Brandon Valley had other thoughts. They're going to be in the big game. Rector nearly lost it. Clark tries to pick his pocket. Gonzalez drives. Too strong. Park finishes up. Addison Park, first points of the game. And there's a steal by Kraus. The jumper, good. Finally, the Lincoln fans have a little something to cheer about, as it has been pretty quiet in here, and with the big lead, the Roosevelt fans, they've made a little noise, but they're kind of, we've seen this before, as Roosevelt calls a 30-second timeout with 6:14 left. We got an update, JJ, from the other action around the state?
No update yet out west, but as we look here again, South Central in the third place game against Dupree, right now up by one in the third quarter there, 36-35. It's been a tight one throughout the day there between South Central and Dupree. Look for that one to go down to the wire.
South Central, that's Burke, Bonesteel, Fairfax. It's been a long time since those schools have been in the state tournament, and I know they had higher aspirations, but I think they're happy nonetheless to be playing on Saturday night rather than Saturday afternoon.
And now just being reported from the Rushmore Plaza Civic Center in Rapid City, it's Platt Geddes up 3-2 over Mobridge Pollock very early on there in the first quarter.
Both schools have been pretty frequent visitors to state basketball, especially Mobridge Pollock, boys and girls. Feed down low, Boggs saves it, but into the hands of Kraus. He'll pick it up. Jaros gets it back. Kraus thinks about the three. It's short. Rebound, tipped loose. Kraus collects it, gets it outside. Jaros, beautiful fake. Floats it up and in. Jaros has one of the best fakes I've seen in high school basketball in a while. He has done that time and again.
Lincoln out to a 6-1 lead here in the third quarter overall. They're still trailing big, but even so, you can see they're playing at a higher level right now than what we saw in the first half, whereas Roosevelt, maybe because of the long intermission there at halftime with all the awards going on, has kind of been lulled into a kind of a half-hearted defense. They're not playing at the same level of intensity that we saw there in that first half, and it's allowed Lincoln to at least get back into this action, down 12 right now. See if the Roosevelt Rough Riders can maybe stem the tide and get back on their offensive roll.
Phillips, Kirkwald in as Howard. Bounce pass, Kirkwald finishes. He's got four and a nice pass by Tyler Howard. Now a little more pressure applied. Jaros loses it right into the scorer's table, out of bounds to Roosevelt. You were ready, man.
I got you. We're not going to let you get hit by the ball.
Well, I was going to hide behind you because it was closer to you than to myself here at the scorer's table. As Cole brings it across the timeline. 5 minute mark here, third period. Here comes the double team. Skip pass to Cole. Howard, another skip pass. Oh, beautiful passing, nice fake. Phillips, up and in with his seventh point. Pretty passing by the Riders. Rector has Kraus, fakes the three, drives. And he'll score. Calvin Kraus, 4 points all in this period. Roosevelt wants to run. Howard is going to be bumped. Foul on the floor. That's going to be on Caleb Rector. And that will be a foul, 14th foul on the Patriots. Timeout on the court. This is the Class AA State Boys Basketball Tournament, SDPB2, South Dakota Public Broadcasting. This is the arena in Sioux Falls, State AA Boys Basketball Tournament. Steve Toon, J.J. Hardigan here, along with our hardworking crew from South Dakota Public Broadcasting, and our camera work tonight provided by students from Washington High School.
They've been here all weekend just like we have, and they've been doing just a great job providing sights and sounds from all around the arena. You're seeing your bird's eye view right now on your TV screens or on your laptops, computers back at home. But just a great job by this crew here all weekend long. We can't thank them enough for the hard work they've done.
Park clears the rebound. Kraus has Jaros in the corner, didn't see him. He'll have to back it out to Krzalich. Now Park works against Kirkwall. The fadeaway short. Clark with the weak side rebound. And also like to thank everyone for logging on to sdpb.org, wherever you may be watching. around the world. And we know there's a lot of people that watch overseas. As Krzyzewicz gets the seal. We've received many kind emails from people serving in the military that have been able to catch our sports coverage and the fine arts coverage. Fadeaway, no good. Phillips with the rebound. Howard the other way for the Rough Riders. Like to thank all our men and women serving in the military. Pass in the paint. Picked off. Jaros clears it away, and he's going to be fouled by Roosevelt. And that is going to be on Chris Phillips. Myers, Dunn in, Rector, Kraus out for Lincoln. And again, thank you to all our men and women serving in the military.
And we've talked about it a couple times throughout this tournament. Sioux Falls Lincoln, as we get back to the action here on the floor, coming in with a group of five in their starting rotation that had never played at the state tournament before. So they've been learning on the run, and it's been a heck of a run for this Sioux Falls Lincoln team. A lot of young talent set to come up and make an impact for a few years to come here for Jeff Halseth and his crew.
He will have to find some guards to replace Jaros and Krzyzewicz. Those are the two main seniors see playing time.
Those young post players, though, and Malik Dunn and Addison Park are special. They handled Zach Hansen and Lane Severin incredibly well throughout that game last night against Pierre, but ultimately those two players who are moving on to play the Division I level for the Governors, just too much at the end of the game for the Lincoln Patriots.
Park picks up his third personal foul, and for a pair of free throws, here's Chris Phillips, 6'3 junior, 70% on the season. Yeah, I mean, this Lincoln team, as far as their post players, they're going to be loaded for the next couple of years. The question for Jeff Halseth, can he find guard play? And he got them both. And Kraus in, Park out for the Patriots. Connor Birchall gets to play guard a lot. He is an underclassman. Luke Myers, who's in the game, he's a senior. Zach Campbell, who has seen some guard play tonight, he is also a senior. Oh, bullet pass out of bounds. Jaros Krzyzewicz miscommunicate. Turnover, gives it back to the Riders.
Well, for Sioux Falls Roosevelt, they've got 9 seniors on this squad this year, 6 juniors. They don't have an underclassman below the junior level. This is a team that's probably going to have to do some rebuilding, and you have to wonder where they're going to be come the start of the season next year. But this is one of the best teams in the state of South Dakota, if not the best team in all three classes across the board. They've had a special, special season here. Lost a tough one last night, but of course they are playing a high level of basketball here. Still something to fight for this third place game tonight.
Roosevelt last year finished 6th at the state tournament, as there's a steal, and Myers comes up with it. People knew they were going to be good, Roosevelt, this year. But this good with their record, I think that surprised even a lot of Roosevelt supporters. Dunn, cross court, 3 ball, no good. And we've got a whistle and a foul. Jaros misfired on the shot. And 3 free throws coming up as Chris Phillips collects his third personal foul for Roosevelt. Fouled the shooter behind the line. 3 free throws for Jaros, 72% on the season. First trip to the line tonight. No good. Boggs at the scorer's table. He'll be in a moment. When you look around the state at these state tournaments, you start thinking of next year, you wonder, the first thing you look at is how many underclassmen get significant playing time. Huron is one of those teams, you know, with bringing Justin Decker back and 3 other starters, you know they're going to be good. The question is, of course, you got to stay healthy, and you have to have the offseason commitment to improve. Rapid City Stevens ought to be very tough next year. Oh, he missed all 3 of them. But Dunn collects it, and a blocking foul. And it's going to be on Roosevelt. And Wilbur picks up his 2nd foul. Inbounds comes to Krzyzewicz. Moody hounds him. Tough shot, no good. Gets his own rebound, no good. but he'll get two free throws. Lincoln still playing hard. And Moody, his second personal foul. So with exactly 2 minutes to go, Krzalich to the line, 1-of-1 on the night. Jaros out and Campbell in for the Patriots. No good on that one. Quickly, Roosevelt in the front court. Koyma into the game now, number 30. Colton Koyma, he had a good tournament. Mostly from beyond the arc. Moody, no good. Rebound to Campbell. Krzalich stops and pops, and it's no good, and it's tipped to Myers. Oh, it's stripped away by Wilbur. Pile up, Krzalich finds Campbell, and the Patriots reset with the new shot clock. Krzalich gets some contact. Foul Roosevelt. And Colton Koyma. And that is his first. Team's fifth. Patriots have struggled a little bit here at the line. As a team, they're just 1 of 6 in this quarter. Got the second of two. Lead still 14 for the Rough Riders. Man-to-man for the Patriots. Three on the way, too strong. And that foul is going to be on Roosevelt. And that will be on Lucas Wilbur. And that is his third. Pass tipped away by Cole, recovered Krzalich. Throws it high to Kraus. Bounce pass done. And we're going to have a foul. And it's going to be charging against Malik Dunn. That is his first. Haven't seen too many charging calls this tournament. 10 seconds difference between the shot clock and the game clock. A little bit of pressure now. Boggs posting up, bounce pass to nobody. And it's out of bounds to Lincoln. Shot clock turned off. Myers in the backcourt. Oh, out of control. Boggs scoops it up. And he is going to be fouled, and he'll get two free throws here as he hit the deck hard. And that is on Luke Myers, his first. As Kirkwald comes to the scorer's table. Boggs hasn't scored a point since the first quarter. Still hasn't. Lucas Wilbur out. Josh Kirkwold in.
Wilbur's not a happy camper as he heads out, stomping his feet on the sideline over there, a little frustrated with himself and the way he's been playing here today. Even so, his team up big, 41-26 here at the end of the third quarter.
Pass up ahead, tapped away by Moody. Can't save it from going out of bounds. It'll stay with Lincoln. Just a shade under 10 seconds left to go in this third quarter of play. The lead 15. Roosevelt was 17 at halftime. Nice finish, Ramin Krzalich. And Cole, can he launch one? He can. It's going to be just off the mark. We're done with three. This is the Class AA State Boys Basketball Tournament on SDPB2 South Dakota Public Broadcasting. The arena in Sioux Falls, the site for the 2013 State AA Boys Basketball Tournament. Stands getting pretty doggone full as we enter the fourth period of this third place game between Lincoln and Roosevelt. Jaros fakes the three. Now the drive. Down low, Park back into the game. Reverse layup. Doesn't go, and Clark wants to run. Campbell chases him. Pass up ahead, out of bounds to Lincoln. Again, while we have a moment here, I'd like to thank our student camera people from Washington High School. The Warriors may not be playing, but Warrior Nation represented. And we've got a timeout called by Coach Halsett. They were just about to have the 10-second count. Great that these students can get some valuable experience here at the state tournament. Coming up later on tonight, Pierre and Brandon Valley for the AA championship.
Right now, 41-28, your score. Let's take a look at some of these numbers here as we have the timeout. Lincoln, this is a rough day shooting from the floor. Really, neither team shooting all that well. Lincoln, 11 of 36, 31% overall from the floor. Sioux Falls Roosevelt, 14 of 37 from the floor. They're shooting at just under 38% on the day. Lincoln, 2 of 9 from three-point land, 22%. Roosevelt, 3 of 9 at a 33% clip. Roosevelt, though, 10 of 13 from the free throw line, shooting 77%, while the Patriots, they've missed 9 free throws today, 31%, 4 of 13 from the charity stripe.
Lincoln outscored Roosevelt 12-8 in that third period of play. They've only made a small dent in this huge Roosevelt lead. Roosevelt has led from the get-go. 17-4 was the score at the end of the first quarter.
It's been a balanced Roosevelt attack. Nobody in double figures for Lincoln. Same story, a fairly balanced attack, but even so, nobody for Lincoln over 7 points. There is one player on the floor with 9. That's Chris Phillips. He's 3 of 4 from the floor here today.
Campbell harassed out top, got a screen, had to give it up to Jaros. Fakes. Campbell. He'll shoot. And it's in and out. And here comes Roosevelt. And they lose it. Kraus ahead, Campbell. Can't save it from out of bounds, just too far out in front of him. And the ball back to the Rough Riders. Kraus comes in, Krzalich in. Park and Campbell head out. Clark into the front court slowly. Kirkwall, the high post. Roosevelt still looking inside. You're right, they've had a balanced attack tonight. Very much like a machine, and then they have an unforced error and turn it over as Nate Cole checks in. And he'll replace Colton Koima. And Lincoln will trigger in the backcourt right in front of the Roosevelt bench. Pressure broken with Jaros in the front court. Phillips comes out to guard him. Jaros looking to fire a shot, steps back. Might have been partially blocked. Dunn has it. Too strong. Kraus up and in. Don't look now, the lead's 11 points. Let's see if Roosevelt can get something back the other way. No.
Both teams have a cap on the rim here right now. It's been a tough, tough shooting day.
Krzalich finishes. The lead down to 9.
Still plenty of time for the Patriots to get back in this game. Just over
5.5 minutes left to go here in the fourth quarter.
Lincoln has been fighting hard, and they've been slowly carving into that lead. Howard up over Jaros, and he'll be fouled, and two free throws coming up for the Rough Riders. Adam Jaros, third personal foul, eighth team foul. 16 fouls have been called against Roosevelt, so it's free throws the rest of the way, and Howard at the line. Wilbur in, Boggs in, Kirkwald and Phillips out for Roosevelt. Tyler Howard again, signed to play basketball, University of Chicago. Misfires, Lincoln clears it. They're down by 10. They've got plenty of time to work with, but they can't afford to misfire on too many possessions. They have to make everything count from here on out. Pass to Dunn, tipped away, stolen by Boggs. Roosevelt looking to drive, nice pass. Lucas Wilbur finishes. Pretty pass to set him up. Krause is going to almost lose it. Back up to a dozen, is done. Spins off balance, tough angle, and the rebound pulled down by Boggs, and he is fouled in the backcourt by Lincoln. And we'll walk down to the other end of the floor for some free throws. Grzalic picks up his third personal foul. This will be the 1-1 coming up here as Addison Park checks in. He'll replace Krause in the Lincoln lineup. Brandon Boggs at the line, 8 points on the night, 3 of 4 at the line, 7 of those points in the first quarter. Got off to the great start, haven't seen much of him since. Got the first. And if he makes this one, he'll be in double figures. And he does, timeout on the court. You're watching the Class AA Boys Basketball Tournament on SDPB2, South Dakota Public Broadcasting. The arena in Sioux Falls has been a busy place for the last week plus with Summit League College Basketball and the AA Boys Basketball Tournament. This is the final day of the AA, last session. Lincoln down by 14. They had cut it to 9 a few moments ago, but Roosevelt has scored 5 unanswered. Krzalic stumbles but gets it away to Charles. Now back to him. And if Lincoln's got a run in them, it's got to start now. Dunn to Rector. He finishes.
This is a Lincoln team that just doesn't know how to quit. Again, they came out just a little flat to start the day, but after halftime, they've been playing some great basketball, actually outscoring Sioux Falls Roosevelt 16-9.
In the corner, Clark, a 3, short, rebound, cleared down by Park. He passes it ahead, I think he got bumped. Threw it right in the hands of a Roosevelt player. Cole pulls it back, now he'll run some clock. Just when it seems like Lincoln's about to make a run or do something great, something bad happens. Cross court, Cole on the drive. Hangs in the air and gets it to go. Tough shot, Nate Cole, he's got 8.
That's a tough kid there, Nate Cole. Taking a look at his numbers throughout this tournament, they've been impressive, just 3 of 10 here today.
Jaros misfires on the 3 as Lucas Wilbur crashed into the table right next to us. Ball up court. And it's collected by Boggs and a timeout called by Roosevelt. They'll maintain possession. And the 14-point lead, 2:53 left. Do we have an update from the B tournament at the moment?
Let's take a look here. We'll start with Platt Geddes actually taking on Mulbridge Pollock right now. That one a 22-18 ball game just at halftime. About to start the third quarter there. And as we look around the rest of the state, South Central
just wrapping up there against Dupree, but it's a late run for Dupree. They outscore South Central in the fourth quarter, 24-15, to secure the win, 64-51, final there. And that one just now going final. So an exciting one there at the B tournament. South Central, who had the lead throughout much of that game, just kind of faltered down the stretch. But from the A tournament, as we mentioned there, just a moment ago, that one at halftime with Platt Geddes taking on Mobridge Pollock, 22-18.
So congratulations to Dupree. They claim third place at the B. Roosevelt trying to hold on here and win at the double A. You know they had higher hopes than that coming in to this tournament as the number one seed. Let's see if they can at least claim third place. Outside, Howard, no good. Rebound, Krzalich, he wants to run. Jaros up ahead, bounce pass, Myers, missed the layup. Wilbur gets it ahead to Boggs. He'll race into the front court. Pass down low and the finish. Boggs with a dozen. And the lead, 16. Coming up on 2 minutes to go. Krzalich stares into the eyes of Clark. Krause will fire the three, and it's no good. And a rebounding foul, and it's going to be on Addison Park. And that is his fourth, so down to the other end of the floor we shall travel. Of course, a lot of people remember Lincoln from 09 on this floor, or not on this floor, in this arena, I should say.
Most years you could say that, but we got a new floor here at the Sioux Falls Arena with the Summit League Tournament providing a new court here, and they've been kind enough to allow the double A's to keep the floor here in Sioux Falls throughout the weekend.
Howard and Clark check out for Roosevelt, probably for the final time in their great careers. Zach Campbell coming in, Addison Park coming out. Tyler Howard will finish the night with 7 points. And Clark with just three, but they made big contributions in so many areas tonight for Roosevelt.
Nice story here today. There's a local radio station in town here in Sioux Falls that does a weekly coaches show, and Lee Taylor on it earlier on today, and he actually got a little emotional talking about his senior core and what they've meant to this program and the turnaround at Roosevelt, especially this season. And as they come out, you see hugs all the way down the line, getting a chance to talk to all these coaches individually. These seniors here have been the heart and soul of this Roosevelt squad for a long time, and Lee Taylor, a class act, couldn't say enough nice things about his boys, and you can see there they all really care about each other there at Sioux Falls Roosevelt.
Krzalich with 9 points now. We'll check out some of the reserves here. Oged Tor into the game, number 40. First a tournament appearance for him for Roosevelt. And here's Zach Eckern. Oh, Moody lost it. More subs line up at the scorer's table. Cole, a three, short. Rebound, Krzalich, three on one. Pass, Jaros, the finish. Got it, 9 points, and an official's timeout. More subs coming in. Coming out, Nate Cole, Trevon Moody. Both seniors, Krause checking out. Now more subs coming in for the Patriots. Vince Walker, he'll check in. And he'll replace the senior, Luke Myers. We'll probably have a few more subs here in the final minute, as Leslie will bring it up. Into the corner, Tor with a shot, and it's short. He gets his own rebound. He'll fire again, too strong off the window. Krzalich stops, Jaros. Birchill now into the game. Walker, a three, good! Vince Walker into the scoring column. Campbell gets a steal. Outside Jaros, the fake. Floats it up, no good. Rebound pulled down by Thompson. He's double teamed, triple teamed. Now here's a foul from behind. Zach Campbell commits that foul on the Roosevelt player. That's Ty Workentin. And that's the third on Zach Campbell. And here come some more reserves as the seniors will leave. Campbell, Jaros, Krzalich. They end their Lincoln careers at the state tournament. Caden Ransom into the game. Also Sean Ladd for Lincoln. Workentin at the line. Nope. Junior fires and no on the second one. Rebound Walker. Burchill. Clock winding down. See if he's gonna put up a shot. He goes to the corner. It's on the way, no good. The ball game is over. Your final score, 52-41. Roosevelt claims third place here at the boys AA basketball tournament.
There you see the final on your screen. We'll get you some team stats here quickly for you as Sioux Falls Roosevelt finishes the day with the win. Just two losses on the season. They came into this tournament just one loss on the year. An impressive season for the Rough Riders, but they finished today's game just under 37%, 17 of 46 overall from the floor, 3 of 12 from three-point land, a good for a 25% clip. Roosevelt 15 of 21 from the free throw line, shooting 71% from the free throw line. We're actually out-rebounded today by Lincoln, 37 to 28, but to Sioux Falls Lincoln had a poor day shooting from the floor, just 34%, 17 of 49, 3 of 13 from long distance at a 23% clip today, and made just 4 of 13 free throw attempts, good for 31% here at the Sioux Falls Arena. Taking a look at some of the other numbers, Boggs your leading scorer today with 14 points for Sioux Falls Roosevelt. Krzalich finishes the day with 9 points for this Lincoln team. The bench for Sioux Falls Roosevelt, impressive today. 16 points off the bench compared to 8 for Sioux Falls Lincoln, and points off the turnovers, huge for the Rough Riders today. They had 14 compared to Lincoln's 2. Let's send it over to Steve now on courtside as he talks things over with
Coach
Lee Taylor.
Coach of the Roosevelt Rough Riders, congratulations on the victory tonight, third place. Obviously a heartbreaking loss last night. What'd you tell your kids after the game last night?
You know, I just told them that one game doesn't define the season they've had. They're a great team, great group of boys. I feel very blessed to have the season we had. And just because we lost last night doesn't change the fact that we had a great season. And I was proud how we responded tonight. And, you know, we got a win and we got third place and we end our season on a win. And that's big. And I'm just so proud of our seniors.
And tell us about some of these young men. You had a senior-laden team. Tell us about some of these young men. I mean, we can read their stats and numbers, but obviously there's more to it than that.
Yeah, I mean, words can't describe the love I have for our seniors and with the dedication and everything they gave to the program. And they put us back where Roosevelt should be, and hopefully that their legacy will carry on for a long time with that group of seniors. And I feel truly blessed to have that group, and I can't be more happier for them.
Coach, congratulations. We'll see you later tonight.
Thank you very much.
Lee Taylor, head man for Sioux Falls Roosevelt, his team third place tonight. Take a timeout, come back with more. This is the Class AA State Boys Basketball Tournament on SDPB2, South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
Free statewide broadcast of this high school championship event is underwritten by the thousands of members of the Friends of South Dakota Public Broadcasting, by Mid-Continent Communications, and by Dakota Bank.
We are back at the arena in Sioux Falls. That's the final score from our third place game. Lincoln made a little bit of a run, cut that lead down to 9, but in the end, they just dug themselves too deep a hole. Roosevelt wins 52-41 with some stats. Here's J.J. Hartigan.
Yeah, let's take a look at the numbers for Sioux Falls Lincoln, who will finish with the fourth place finish here at the state tournament this year. Nobody in double figures today, but Nermeen Krzalik leading the way with 9 points, 7 rebounds on 3 of 10 shooting. Finished the day 0 of 2 from three-point land, had 5 turnovers, 1 assist, 1 steal in 26 minutes. 7 points on the day from Caleb Rector. He had 4 rebounds on 3 of 7 shooting today. 2 steals and an assist in 21 minutes. 9 points as well, by the way, for Adam Jaros. 4 of 12 shooting, just 1 of 6 from 3. Missed all 3 of his free throws here today. 9 points, 1 rebound, 7 turnovers for Jaros in 25 minutes. Rough day on the floor for him, even though he did finish with those 9 points. Some other scores for Sioux Falls Lincoln. 6 points for Calvin Krause on 3 of 7 shooting. He had 8 rebounds on the day and 4 steals in 23 minutes. Nice way to finish his season here at Sioux Falls Lincoln. And some other scores, 4 points from Malik Dunn, 3 points from Vince Walker, and 2 points on the day from Addison Park, and 1 for Caden Ransom. For Sioux Falls Roosevelt, they finished the day 37% from the floor, 25% from long distance, and 71% from the free throw line. They get 14 points in the win from Brandon Boggs, 4 rebounds on 3 of 7 shooting here today. He finished 7 of 8 from the free throw line with 4 steals in 20 minutes. 9 points on the day from Chris Phillips. You get 8 points from Nate Cole, 7 points from Tyler Howard on 2 of 8 shooting. 4 points on the day from Josh Kirkwood, 3 points from Colton Koima, and from Jeremiah Clark. And that'll wrap up the scoring for Sioux Falls Roosevelt. But again, they were out-rebounded today by Sioux Falls Lincoln, 37-28, even though Roosevelt did roll to the 52-41 win.
Points in the paint, even up at 26 apiece. Points off turnovers, 14-2 advantage Roosevelt. Bench points, 16-8 advantage Roosevelt. But Lincoln outscored Roosevelt in the second half, outscoring them 12-8 in the third quarter and 13-11 in the fourth quarter. But it was that first quarter disastrous for Lincoln, and that's what did them in tonight in the third place game. We're going to take a timeout and come back with more. The championship game waiting in the wings. This is the Class AA State Boys Basketball Tournament on SDPB2, South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
Free statewide broadcast of this high school championship event is underwritten by the thousands of members of the Friends of South Dakota Public Broadcasting, by Farmers Union Insurance, Independent Insurance Agents of South Dakota, SDN Communications, and First Bank and Trust.